mode. Today concept name is overriding. What do you mean by overriding, madam? Do you know anything? Overriding.
Overriding.
What do you mean by overriding?
Maybe if we have limited number of memory locations and we want to load more data into that, so that scenario will get that overriding concept.
Overriding. So overloading, we discussed the concept is overriding. Overriding. What do you mean by overriding? If at all, a function what is overriding? If at all a function.
So are you asking me or are you telling?
No, I'm writing. Overriding. If at all a function existing in parent class then that function if we write in child class if at all a function existing in parent class, then that function, if we write in child class, then that concept is called, overriding. If at all a function existing in parent class, then that function, if we write in child class, then that concept is called overriding. So whatever we have in parent class, function should be there in child class. So in child class, if you want to write any extra function, you can write it. But whatever we have in parent class, function should be there in child class. So that's why that is called overriding. If at all a function existing in parent class, then that function, if we write in child class, then that concept is called overriding. So whatever we have in parent class, that function should be there in child class. In child class, whatever you want, you can write it. But that parent class function should be there in child class. That is the concept of overriding. If at all a function existing in parent class, then that function, if you write in child class, then that concept is called overriding. So what is parent class? What is child class? How we can declare, sir? So parent class means if you take any class in first time, so that is called parent class. If you take second time, if you take next time, so or if you want to take any class next time or second time, or so that is called child class. So if at all a function existing in parent class, then that function, if you write in child class, then that concept is called overriding. Whatever we have in parent class, function should be there in child class. That is very, very important. In child class, if you want any extra functions, you can write it. But whatever we have in parent class, function should be there in child class. That is the only one restriction. Whatever we have in parent class, function should be there in child class. In child class, if you want write any extra functions, you can write it. But whatever you have in parent class, function should be there in child class. That is the concept of overriding. If at all a function existing in parent class, then that function, if you write in child class, then that concept is called overriding. Right. I'm going to Eclipse. Not Marvin. Go to SRC, take the new class, class name is over. Keep the mark, just no need to keep the mark, click on finish. Not over. Go to SRC, take the new class, class name is model 1. Click on finish. I am taking the class model 1. I am writing the functions. Public static function or non-static function. Public void call. I am taking one class. The class name is model 1. I am writing the functions now. SYSO control space. Model 1 call. Right. I wrote one function, call function. I wrote copy control V model 1 call, model 1 message, reject. Model 1 call, model 1 message, model 1 reject. Save. And taking to another class. Go to SRC, take the new class. Model 2. So, whatever we have in parent class, that function should be there in child class. Model 1, we have call, message, reject. So, model 2 also we have call, message, reject. So model 2 reject, model 2 call, model 2 message, model 2 reject. So if you want any extra functions, you can write it. Whatever you want, you can write it. Like public void Pavani. SYSO control space. Pavani. Model 2 Pavani. Yes. Whatever we have in parent class, that function should be there in child class. In child class, if you want any extra functions, you can write it. That's your choice. Okay. Model 2 Pavani. Okay. Right. If you want to call the take new class over, class name is over. Keep the mark public static void, meaning click on finish. I want to call the model one functions. How we can call the model one functions? All are non-static. So if it is non-static, we need to create the object. How to create the object? To model one m1 equal to new model one. Model one m1 equal to new model one. M1 dot class, sorry, call m1 dot call m1 dot reject m1 dot message. Right, we can get all the functions. Right, model 2. I want to call the model 2 functions. How we can call model 2 m2 equal to new model 2 m2 dot call m2 dot message m2 dot reject m2 dot powering. Right, like we can call the function. This is a concept to overriding concept. Whatever we have in parent class, that parent class function should be there in child class. That concept is called overriding. If at all a function existing in parent class, that function if we write in child class, then that concept is called overriding. Overriding concept is over. Save, click on run. That message will print here. Model 1 call, model 1 reject, model 1 message, model 2 call, model 2 message, model 2 reject, model 2 pop. Right. So today, connecting concept to interface. What is interface? Next concept to interface. Interface, connecting concept to very, very important concept. Using this concept only we can enter into Selenium. Interface. What is interface? My definition is, what is interface? Interface is something created between two somethings. Interface is something created between two somethings. In between two somethings, I am creating something, so that is called interface. In between two somethings, I created something, so that is called interface. So we have two somethings. For example, we have two somethings. In between two somethings, I am creating something, so that is called interface. In between two somethings, I am creating something, so that is called interface. So before going to interface concept, I will tell you one small story. Okay, what is that story? Nokia people, sorry, not Nokia people, iPhone people. So they want to maintain some common features in each and every model. In iPhone, we have different models. i4, i3, i6, i7, i10, i9, i10, i8. So different models. So finally, that iPhone people decided they want to maintain some common features in each and every model. In iPhone, they want to maintain some common features in each and every model. If it is iPhone 3, iPhone 4, iPhone 5, iPhone 6, iPhone 7, iPhone 8. So we have different models. So they want to maintain some common features in each and every model. For example, so if they want to maintain some common features in each and every model, they are creating one interface. 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 So this is the interface. They are creating one interface. So what they want to maintain commonly in each and every model, they will keep in one interface. Just like they want to maintain commonly call, reject, message. This just they want to maintain these three functions in each and every model. They want to maintain these three functions in each and every model. If it is iPhone 3, iPhone 5, iPhone 5, iPhone 6, iPhone 7, iPhone 8, whatever it is. So they want to maintain these common functions in each and every model. So that's the reason they are creating one interface and they will keeping, they are keeping in interface. If they want to introduce any model into market, first of all, they will install this interface. After that, if they want any more, after that, if they want to add any extra function, they can add it. But each and every model should have this interface functions. Why? Because already they decided. If they want to introduce any model into market, first of all, they want to keep this interface functions first of all. After that, if they want any extra function, they can add it. That is not big issue. But each and every model should contain this interface functions. That is iPhone goal. So call function, reject function, message function. They want to maintain each and every model. So after that, if they want to introduce any model, compulsory. After that, if they want to introduce any model into market, compulsory they will install this interface functions. After that, if they want any extra function, they can add it. That is no restrictions. But if it is any model, iPhone 3, iPhone 5, iPhone 6, iPhone 8, iPhone 10, whatever it is. So they want to maintain some common features in each and every model. So after that, if they want to add or introduce any extra function, they can add it. But that whatever we have in interface, that interface function should be there in each and every model. That is the concept. Okay, right. Now I am creating one interface. How to create interface? Just simple. Just go to SRC, take the new interface. In the place of class, I am taking interface only. Interface name is iPhone. Click on finish. In the iPhone, I want to maintain some common features in each and every model. iPhone 3, iPhone 5, iPhone 6. So, I am writing the functions. Public void call. I want to maintain this call function each and every model. Public public void message required reject. These three functions I want to maintain each and every model. I want to maintain each and every model. So what is the difference between class function and interface function? Tell me, madam. What is the difference between class function and interface function? What is the difference between class function and interface function?
In the class, you write again that statement in each function.
Here you should remember only one point. This is also very very important interview question. So class function having function body, but interface function don't have any function body. That is the difference. Okay. Right. So here is no function body, just so I want to maintain commonly on each and every model. So there is a reason I am taking one interface, I am writing the functions, right? So now I want to check model one having this interface functions or not. How we can check? So model one implements, model one implements, implements iPhone. So whatever we have in iPhone functions, if it is in man model one, so it will not show any error. But if it is not there, it will show error. For example, so call function is not there, for example control X, automatically it will show error, automatically it will show error. So whatever we have in interface, that function should be there in control. What control? Yes, whatever we have in interface, that function should be there in each and every model. Model one having this three functions, so call, reject, to message, so it will not show any error. Okay, right, save. Next, model two implements iPhone. Model two model to implement iPhone. So here we have a extra function, but it will not show any error. Why? Because whatever we have in interface, that function should be there in model one or model two, so it will not show any error, right? Come to concept. Now here we will learn only one line, only this line. First we are learning this concept, that concept. So here we are learning only one line, only one line purpose. What is the line? Oh God. Class name, reference name equal to new. Class name, reference name, class name, reference name equal to new class name. This is the line already we learned, right? Class name, reference name equal to new class name. Class name, reference name equal to new class name. Class name, reference name equal to new class name. Already we learned class name, reference name equal to new class name. Already we learned. But today concept is very very important. Class name, reference name equal to new class name, already in the first class we learned. But today concept is very different. Interface name, interface name, a reference name equal to new class name. Only for this line purpose we learned Java, only one line. So what is this line, sir? So without saying Java directly, if you say like interface name, reference name equal to new class name, I can get it, yeah? So what is the use of this concept? So only for only this line purpose we learn Java. So without knowing this all Java concept, directly we can learn Selenium also. But whenever you are facing the interview, that time they may ask you like, you know, 50% questions in Selenium, 50% questions in Java. That's the reason we learned Java. So otherwise no need Java. Interface name, reference name equal to new class name. Interface is iPhone, reference name I equal to new class name. Any class you can, model one you can take or model two you can take. New model one, interface I dot call, we can get it. I dot message, I dot reject, right? Okay, Next, model 2. I1 dot, sorry, iPhone I1 equal to new model 2. I1 dot call I1 dot message I1 dot reject I1 dot WhatsApp work, sorry I1 dot Pavani we can't get. Why?
Because in interface we have only three functions.
Here we can get Pavani. So class to class we can call the all the class functions. To interface we can call the only interface functions only. So there is no Pavani in interface. There is no Pavani in interface. Only we can call the only interface functions only. That is the concept. Interface function. Interface. Through class reference, we can call the all class functions. Here observe, we can call the all class functions. Through interface, we can call the only interface functions only. That is the concept, interface concept. What we learned from Java, only we learned only one line from Java. That concept name is interface name, reference name equal to new class name. Interface name, reference name equal to new class name. That is the concept. Interface name, reference name equal to new class name. Interface iPhone, I equal to new class name. Any class, model 1 you can take it, model 2 also you can take it.